I'm Jason LeDuc. It is the fourth Thursday of the month. This is where I take over from Michelle Davis for the Geeks R Sexy show, and we talk about business and success. We bring on great business owners from Las Vegas and beyond, talk about the lessons they've learned and how they've learned to be successful with their businesses here in Las Vegas. So welcome. Thank you for joining us in 2019, and please stick with us through 2019. Our first guest today is Lindsay Parker. She is the owner of We Do Shots, and this is a really incredible idea. I don't know why anybody hasn't thought of this before. Lindsay and her team are photographers, and they do headshots, but they have a truck, and they bring the truck to you. So if you're a business owner and you need to get headshots for your executives or your team, Lindsay comes right to you and does it. Doesn't need to set anything up in your place. You don't need to go anywhere. They come to you, and they do it right in their truck. We're going to talk about the truck in a little bit. But Lindsay is passionate about taking an old process and finding ways to enhance it. And this is where We Do Shots comes in. And that's exactly what she's done. They take those professional headshots for you, and they bring it right to you. So, Lindsay, welcome to the show.
Thank you for having me.
Thank you for being here today. So, mobile headshots in a truck. How did all of this come about?
Yeah. So, like you said, I mean, it's new to Las Vegas, but basically the idea came to me from my previous employer. I was an office manager, and one of the many, many, many tasks that I had was to hire a photographer to come in and take company headshots. Never doing this before, I didn't really know what I was getting into with that, but I'm, you know, so I embark on this idea, and I get the photographer in there. They set up in our conference room and ended up taking quite a while for them to set up, but even more importantly, it took my entire day to help them. So I didn't realize that was something I would be facilitating when I took that task on, but it was. And then there are certain costs associated with that and just the time. So anyways, I come home from work that day, and I'm talking to my husband, who happens to be a photographer, and I, you know, explain my entire day to him, and I simply say, I'm like, there has to be a better way to do this. Why can't somebody just pull up to my office building, take the pictures, and be on their way? And, you know, we sort of let that idea stew for a while, and, you know, we decided, like, we could do this. We could be those people who create this process. I mean, clearly there is a need for it, and we just thought, you know, we could be the ones to do it.
Well, and I think you are the ones doing it, and because I don't know of anybody else doing it. And if they're out there, it doesn't sound like they're doing it quite as good as you are. But also, you put this together really quickly. When did you start talking about this?
So we really started thinking about this seriously in like June or July of last year, was actually when this task was given to me. And I mean, from the day that
task was given to you by
By me. And basically, we ran with it. So from July till now, but we didn't actually launch until the beginning of December of last year, so we're really new. But you know, like I said, I feel like it's so much more than just taking pictures. It's about giving you know, our customers a different experience. Getting a headshot should be exciting and fun. It represents your business, and so having, you know, my business background but also my office manager background, I kind of was able to see both sides. So I know how much work goes into behind the scenes and getting ready for the headshots, but I also know what it's like to be the customer getting one.
Yeah, the last thing you want is, if you're a business owner or you're the person who's got to get the headshot and you're waiting for your turn, the last thing you want is this to be a drag, because you've got other things you're thinking about, and you might be enthusiastic about it when you show up, but if you've got to wait 15 minutes, 20 minutes, 45 minutes, it could be a real drag, and that'll bring your energy down, and that'll affect the outcome of those. It'll affect what the pictures look like.
Oh, absolutely.
So you had the idea in the July-ish time frame, June, July, but didn't start until actually start taking pictures until December. So tell us about the challenges that you had to overcome to go from July to December.
Sure. So really there were two main challenges. The first one is, you know, taking the leap of faith, and, you know, leaving some of the security and the comforts of having, you know, a 9-to-5 behind. We decided, you know, early on that if we were going to do this, we were going to 100% do this. And, you know, you can't just decide you want to try something like this. It's completely new, like you said, to the area. It's new to the industry. It's very disruptive. And so for us, we needed to be 100% from the beginning. That was very scary.
This is a hard one to do as a side hustle.
Yes, this cannot be. Not if you want to do well.
Yeah.
You can absolutely but I think you're going to see that your success is limited by the amount of time you put in. So that was definitely a challenge, just, you know, getting ready to take the plunge and go for it. But I think the second obstacle we faced was figuring out, you know, what the heck do we do to get this truck together to actually be a photo studio? We knew right away the type of truck we wanted, but it was like figuring out just some of the details, you know, how large should it be? How many people are we trying to accommodate inside? And then, of course, for us, luckily, my husband being a photographer, he knew the equipment we would need.
Okay.
So that part was not a challenge. It was just the truck in itself.
Okay.
How do you get the lighting to work and, you know, air conditioning? And, you know, we live in Las Vegas, so that's a factor. There was a lot.
Anytime you're trying to take something that's fixed and make it mobile, it's not as simple as just throwing a bunch of stuff in the back of a truck.
Definitely not.
But we've got some pictures of your truck.
Yes.
So, Nick, let's see if we can put up a picture of the exterior of the truck. And I don't know if we'll be able to see that on... Oh, we can see it on the monitor. So this is the exterior of the truck. So tell us what kind of truck it is.
Yeah.
And where you found it. Because that's an interesting story as well.
Yeah. So it's a Ford Transit. And basically, the way these particular trucks work is you can actually pick the type of back end that you want it to be. So you'll see a lot of, like, plumbers have these similar trucks. It's also more commonly a FedEx truck was the model we chose because it actually has two access to the truck on two sides. Mm-hmm. And that was really important to us for functionality reasons. But then the other picture that we have is of the inside of the truck. And so this perspective is kind of fun because this is what you're looking at when you walk into the truck. So you walk up the stairs, there's a little waiting area to the right, to the left there's a little prep station, and if you keep walking further, you can see we've got our little mini fridge with lots of drinks because again, we know it's hot. And then our different backgrounds. And we have quite a few to choose from. So we can do more traditional photos. Mm-hmm. We can also do more fun photos. But yeah, that's an idea of what that looks like. And then this perspective is if you're the person getting your picture taken.
Yep.
And one of the things I like to point out is that monitor that you see that has our little logo on it, that actually shows you your picture in real time.
Okay.
So that's one of the things that we do very differently from other photography studios is that you see in real time what your picture looks like. So you know immediately, am I having a good hair day? Is my, you know, shirt button correctly?
Do I need
is
to
my
sit
tie
up a little straighter, maybe suck it in like I have to do when I get a picture taken?
Exactly. So there's no surprise. You don't have to wait that 2 weeks to determine whether or not that picture worked for you. You know immediately.
Awesome.
Yeah.
So you guys, when you take headshots, you have a couple different kind of headshots you take for people. Tell us about those and why that's important that you do, that you have different kinds of headshots if you're a professional.
Sure. So yeah, we have different types of backgrounds that I think really cater to the different type of industries that require headshots. I think a lot of times people get stuck in this sort of old school idea that a headshot has to be, you know, suit and tie and professional. Mm-hmm. And that's just not always the case. A lot of times I feel, especially with social media nowadays, you want to represent yourself as professional as possible, but that's applicable to your business. So for example, if you own a flower shop, I would not expect the owner of a flower shop to be in a suit and tie. I think it would be great if the owner of a flower shop was wearing maybe a denim shirt or maybe, you know, something that was cuffed or, you know, so we can work with that. Mm-hmm. And so it can be, like I said, it's professional and there's still really high quality photos, but they can be done in a way that's not as, like, I call it stiff. It's not as stiff. It's a lot more fun. And the backgrounds are great. Mm-hmm. And so you'll stand out. And that's the whole point.
So there's two pieces, really, is that the concept that you agree upon with the client before you do the shots. And then there's the nuts and bolts photography, which you guys also do very, very well.
Yes.
Awesome.
Yes.
So what is coming up for We Do Shots in 2019?
Sure. So one of the things we're really excited about is, you know, we are trying to just get out in the community, sort of share what we're all about and find ways to change the way people view headshots. It's not something that you need to get once every 3 years. It's something you should update every year and have a more fun headshot, a more classical sort of professional style headshot. But again, they're all great quality. So what you'll see from us is a lot of just advertising. You'll see us on the road a lot. We're constantly driving back and forth. I swear it's like from one side of the strip to the other. But also joining a lot of some of the trade shows and conventions that are happening. You'll see us, we're a vendor in quite a few already starting this year, right in January, and we have one in February, we have one in March. So you'll continue to see us with that.
Well, and if you want them to come to your event, I'm sure that's something that you could work out with them, right?
Absolutely, we're very interested in that. So if that's anything, if what we do seems like something that would work well with your, you know, just your network of clients or customers, we'd be happy to help.
Awesome. So who are you looking to connect with in 2019 to grow your business?
So we're looking to connect with anybody who's looking to enhance their professional image. And again, that could be whatever it is for your business. So if you're a real estate agent, insurance provider, an accountant, a lawyer, you know, something in those classic areas, absolutely we're happy to help you. But what we're really looking to do is sort of challenge this idea of what a headshot should be. Mm-hmm. So anybody who's looking to just sort of revamp their current one or create an, or get a new one for the first time, that's what we're looking for.
Awesome. Awesome. And how can our audience reach you if they want to get their headshots done?
Yeah, so we have Facebook. So Facebook/WeDoShots. We're on Instagram, so you can follow us at WeDoShots. And of course, our website, that's the best place to go. We have videos of the truck. It's actually how you can book an appointment with us if you're interested. It's okay. WeDoShots.com.
All right, so go to WeDoShots.com. Not right now. We have two more guests and a panel discussion coming up. So later on, go to WeDoShots.com. Get Lindsay and her husband to come work with you on a concept for the right headshot for you and have them come right to you and do the headshots right in their very comfortable truck.
Mm-hmm.
So, all right, thank you for being here. We're going to be right back with Sarah Binger from Dream Builder Bookkeeper. Stay right here. This is Geeks R Sexy.